It is quite interesting to look a little bit at the statistics of what types of meteorites are present in our collections. This is what is shown here in these pie charts that were constructed using the MedBull database. From the first pie chart, we learn that the vast majority of meteorites come from undifferentiated parent bodies. So these are primitive parent bodies that never developed a core and a mantle. Those that developed a core and a mantle are the differentiated or the intermediate meteorites. Now, when we look at the differentiated meteorites, most of these are howardites, eucrites, and diogenites, which collectively are called HED meteorites and are thought to come from the asteroid Vesta. So these are all mantle rocks. And some more mantle rocks are angrites and aubrites. So these are almost two-thirds to three-quarters of the differentiated meteorites. Now the intermediates are the pallasites and the mesosiderites, and finally the cores of the asteroids are the irons, which hold about a quarter of all the differentiated meteorites. Now when we go back to the undifferentiated, which are the vast majority, more than 90%, we see that among the undifferentiated, first that the undifferentiated are the chondrites, which is quite important, and that among the chondrites, the H, L, and LL chondrites, so the ordinary chondrites, have about 95%. This is why they're called ordinary chondrites. All the other chondrite groups are much smaller. Of course, for example, the important carbonaceous chondrites have only 4% of all the chondrites, of all the undifferentiated meteorites. Now, because the carbonaceous chondrites are particularly interesting because they are very primitive and very close to the solar composition, these are shown here. And among the carbonaceous chondrites, the most important group class, the most important group of this class are the CI chondrites, which have approximately the composition of the Sun, except for hydrogen, helium, and volatiles, of course. But the CI chondrites, they only have a share, the smallest share actually, of about 0.4%. The most abundant among the carbonaceous chondrites are the CO and the CM, which together also form a clan. They hold about 50% of the carbonaceous chondrites. And the second most groups are CV and CK, which again together form a clan. Clan meaning that they have a lot of similar characteristics, and they are the second most abundant with about 36%, and COCM have more than 50%. So this is just a very brief demonstration of what types of meteorites are present in our group, that the CI chondrites that are so important are very small, that also the carbonaceous chondrites are very small, that the ordinary chondrites are those that are most abundant in our collections. And of course, it would be possible to construct other pie charts, also, for example, discriminating between faults and finds, and maybe petrologic type, a weathering degree or so would also be interesting. So this is just a very brief glimpse at some of the most interesting statistics of meteorite types.